In this video, we discuss an interesting method using diagrammatical approach to solve problems on blood relation tests. Before discussing the problems, let us see the following blood relations. Mother's or father's son is called brother. Mother's or father's daughter is called sister. Mother's or father's brother is called uncle. Mother's or father's sister is called aunt. Mother's or father's father is called grandfather. Mother's or father's mother is called grandmother. Son's wife is called daughter-in-law. Daughter's husband is called son-in-law. Husband's or wife's sister is called sister-in-law. Husband's or wife's brother is called brother-in-law. Brother's son or sister's son is called nephew. Brother's daughter or sister's daughter is called niece. Uncle's or aunt's son or daughter is called cousin. Sister's husband is called brother-in-law. Brother's wife is called sister-in-law. Grandson's or granddaughter's daughter is called great-granddaughter. Relation on the mother's side is called maternal, while that on the father's side is called paternal. Now let us see some notations that we'll be using throughout this presentation. To represent a female character, we use a circle. For example, to represent a mother or a niece or an aunt, we use a circle since each is a female character. To represent a male character, we use a rectangle. For example, to represent an uncle or a grandfather or a brother, we use a rectangle since each is a male character. Let us see now how to represent siblings. For example, if Anil is the brother of Sushma, then we can diagrammatically represent it as follows. Note that Anil is a male character and Sushma is a female character. So to represent Anil, we use a rectangle, and to represent Sushma, we use a circle. We draw the characters Anil and Sushma at the same horizontal level, that is, side by side, as you see in the figure, and we draw one horizontal line between these two characters. So, whenever two characters are drawn at the same horizontal level with a line between them, then they are siblings. Thus, we interpret from this figure that Anil is the brother of Sushma, or in other words, Sushma is the brother of Anil. Now let us see how to represent a couple. For example, if Krish is the husband of Ananya, then we can diagrammatically represent it as follows. Note that Krish is a male character and Ananya is a female character, and hence we use a rectangle for representing Krish and we use a circle for representing Ananya. Since they are a couple, we draw both these characters, Krish and Ananya, at the same horizontal level, and we draw two horizontal lines between them, as you see in the figure. So whenever a female character and a male character are drawn at the same horizontal level, with two lines between them, then they are a couple. Thus, we interpret from this figure that Ananya is the wife of Krish, or in other words, Krish is the husband of Ananya. We shall now see how to represent children of a couple. For example, if Anil and Sushma are children of Krish and Ananya, then we can diagrammatically represent it as follows. Here, Anil and Krish are male characters, and therefore we use rectangles to represent them, and Sushma and Ananya are female characters, and therefore we use circles to represent them. First, since Krish and Ananya is a couple, we represent them as you see in the figure by drawing them at the same horizontal level, say at level 1, and we draw two horizontal lines between them to indicate that they are a couple. Next, we represent the characters Anil and Sushma as you see in the figure, one level beneath level 1, say at level 2. Now, since Anil and Sushma are siblings, we draw one horizontal line between them. Next, we draw vertical lines, one between Krish and Anil and the other between Krish and Sushma. These two vertical lines indicate that Anil and Sushma are children of Krish. In other words, Krish is the father of Anil and Sushma. We can also represent the relation between the couple and their children in this way also, as you see in the figure, by drawing two vertical lines, one between Ananya and Anil and the other between Ananya and Sushma. Understand that both the figures interpret the same relation. Thus, from the figure, we interpret that Krish and Ananya are parents of Anil and Sushma. Or in other words, Anil and Sushma are the children of the couple Ananya and Krish. Now let us see how to represent grandparents and grandchildren. For example, if Rakesh is the father of Ananya and Anil is the son of Ananya, then Anil is the grandson of Rakesh. It can be diagrammatically represented as follows. Here we have three characters, Rakesh, Ananya and Anil. Rakesh and Anil are male characters, and therefore we use rectangles to represent them. And Ananya is a female character, and therefore we use a circle to represent her. First, we represent Rakesh at level 1, say. Since Ananya is the daughter of Rakesh, we draw her one level beneath level 1, say at level 2. We draw a vertical line between the characters Rakesh and Ananya to indicate that Rakesh is the father of Ananya, or in other words, Ananya is the daughter of Rakesh. Next, we draw Anil one level beneath level 2, say at level 3. We draw a vertical line between Ananya and Anil to indicate that Anil is the son of Ananya, or in other words, Ananya is the mother of Anil. Thus, from the figure, we interpret that Ananya is the daughter of Rakesh and Anil is the son of Ananya, and hence Anil is the grandson of Rakesh, or in other words, Rakesh is the grandfather of Anil. Now we shall discuss problems on blood relation tests. Pointing to a boy, Dinesh said, "His father is the only son of my mother. How is the boy related to Dinesh?" Here the person who speaks is Dinesh and the person of reference is the boy. In the sentence of the problem, look out for the is or the was phrase. Here in this example, we see the is phrase. I have colored it in blue color. So given a problem, in the sentence of the problem, look out for the is or the was phrase. Now, what appears before the is phrase is called the first part of the sentence, and what appears after the is phrase is called as the second part of the sentence. I repeat, what appears before the is phrase is called the first part of the sentence, and what appears after the is phrase is the second part of the sentence. Here in this example, the first part of the sentence is his father, and the second part of the sentence is the only son of my mother. Throughout this presentation, I will work on the second part of the sentence first and then on the first part of the sentence. Now, initially I work on the second part of the sentence. The second part of the sentence is the only son of my mother. The technique I use here is working from the last. So I start from the last phrase of the second part of the sentence, which is my mother. So here my mother refers to Dinesh's mother. So first we draw Dinesh, and then Dinesh's mother as shown in the figure using the notations discussed in the introduction. Again, look at the second part of the sentence. Now the phrase only son of my mother is none other than Dinesh. So the character described by the second part of the sentence is Dinesh, and we give the character a color shade as shown in the figure. Now we have completed working on the second part of the sentence. So we start working on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is his father. Here, his father refers to the boy's father. So first draw the boy, and then the next, and next the boy's father. So the character described by the first part of the sentence is the boy's father, and we give a color shade to this character as shown in the figure. Now the two characters with color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So we merge these two characters in figure 1 and figure 2 and obtain figure 3 as you see on the screen. So Dinesh and the boy's father are the one and the same character. Now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the boy related to Dinesh? So from the figure we interpret that the boy's father is Dinesh. So hence the boy is Dinesh's son. Next problem. Introducing a boy, Amarjeet said he is the son of the daughter of my father. How is the boy related to Amarjeet? Here the person who speaks is Amarjeet and the person of reference is a boy. The sentence that you find in the statement of the problem is, he is the son of the daughter of my father. So the first part of the sentence is he, and the second part of the sentence is the son of the daughter of my father. We start working on the second part of the sentence first. We work from the last. So here my father refers to Amarjeet's father. So first we draw Amarjeet, and then Amarjeet's father. Daughter of my father means daughter of Amarjeet's father. So that will be Amarjeet's sister. son of the daughter of my father. So that is the daughter of Amarjeet's sister. Sorry, son of Amarjeet's sister. So that is the character described by the second part of the sentence. So which is given a color shade as you see in the figure. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is he. So here he refers to the boy. So we draw the boy. Now the boy is the character described by the first part of the sentence. So both the characters, as we see with color shades, represent the same character. So we merge these two characters and obtain a figure as you see on the screen. Now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the boy related to Amarjeet? So from the figure we interpret that the boy is the son of Amarjeet's sister. I repeat, the boy is the son of Amarjeet's sister. So therefore the boy is Amarjeet's sister's son. Therefore the boy is the nephew of Amarjeet, and that's the answer. Next problem. A boy says to a girl, your father's wife is the only daughter of my maternal grandmother. How is the boy related to the girl? So here the person who speaks is the boy and the person of reference is the girl. The sentence that you find in the statement of the problem is, your father's wife is the only daughter of my maternal grandmother. The first part of the sentence in this example is your father's wife, and the second part of the sentence is the only daughter of my maternal grandmother. So first we start working on the second part of the sentence, and we start working from the last. So my maternal grandmother here refers to the boy's maternal grandmother. So first we draw the boy, boy's mother, and the mother of the boy's mother. So that character will be the boy's maternal grandmother. And only daughter of my maternal grandmother, only daughter of my maternal grandmother is none other than the boy's mother. So that is the character that is described by the second part of the sentence. So that is the boy's mother. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is your father's wife. So here your father's wife refers to the girl's father's wife. So first we draw the girl, so girl's father, then and then the girl's father's wife. So girl's father's wife is none other than the girl's mother. So the character described by the first part of the sentence is the girl's mother, and we give a color shade to this character. Now the characters which we see with a color shade in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So therefore we merge these two characters to obtain a figure as you see in figure 3. So the boy's mother and the girl's mother are the one and the same character. Now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the boy related to the girl? So since boy's mother and girl's mother are the one and the same, the boy is none other than the brother of the girl. Next question. Introducing a man, a woman said, he is the only son of the mother of my mother. How is the woman related to the man? So here the person who speaks is a woman and the person of reference is a man. The sentence that you see in the statement of the problem is, he is the only son of the mother of my mother. Here the first part of the sentence is he, and the second part of the sentence is the only son of the mother of my mother. We start working on the second part of the sentence first. that is the only son of the mother of my mother. We start working from the last. So here my mother refers to the woman's mother. So first we draw the woman and then the woman's mother. Mother of my mother means the mother of the woman's mother. So suppose we call the character woman's mother as A, then A's mother will be B. Only son of the mother of my mother means B's son, right? So that is what you see in the figure. So that's the character that is described by the second part of the sentence. So therefore we give a color shade to the character. So we have completed interpreting the second part of the sentence. Now we move to the first part of the sentence. So here he refers to the man. So we draw the man. So the man is the character described by the first part of the sentence, and therefore we give a color shade to that character. Now the characters with color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So therefore we merge those two characters. We merge those two characters, B, son and man, to obtain the figure as you see on the screen. So now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the woman related to the man? Now from the figure we see that the woman's mother or the character A and the man are siblings, right? So therefore the woman is the man's sister's daughter. I repeat, the woman is the man's sister's daughter. So therefore the woman is the niece of the man. So that's the answer. Next problem. Introducing a lady, a man said, her mother is the only daughter of my mother-in-law. How is the man related to the lady? Here the person who speaks is a man and the person of reference is a lady. The sentence that you find in the statement of the problem is, her mother is the only daughter of my mother-in-law. So the first part of the sentence is her mother, and the second part of the sentence is the only daughter of my mother-in-law. First we start working on the second part of the sentence and we start from the last. So my mother-in-law refers to the man's mother-in-law. So first we draw the man. So man's wife's mother is nothing but the man's mother-in-law. So that we have drawn now. Only daughter of my mother-in-law means it is none other than the man's wife. So we have completed interpreting the second part. So the character described by the second part of the sentence is the man's wife. So therefore we give a color shade to this character. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is her mother. So here her mother refers to the lady's mother. So first we draw the lady and then the lady's mother. So therefore the character described by the first part of the sentence is the lady's mother, and therefore we give a color shade to that character. Now the characters given color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So therefore we merge these two characters to obtain a figure as you see on the screen now as figure 3. Now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the man related to the lady, right? So the lady's mother, so the lady's mother, the man is nothing but the lady's mother's husband. So therefore the man is the father of the lady, and that's the answer, right? Next problem. Pointing to a boy in the photograph, Rina said, he is the only son of the only child of my grandfather. So here the person who speaks is Rina and the person of reference is a boy. The sentence that you see in the statement of the problem is, he is the only son of the only child of my grandfather. The first part of the sentence is he, and the second part of the sentence is the only son of the only child of my grandfather. First, we start working on the second part of the sentence. The second part of the sentence is the only son of the only child of my grandfather. So we start from the last. So my grandfather refers to Reena's grandfather. So we draw Reena first, and then Reena's parent, and then Reena's grandparent. Since we don't know the gender of Reena's parent, it may be her mother or her father, that doesn't matter. Since it is not mentioned, we don't enclose it either in a circle or a rectangle. Now, only child of my grandfather, it means that it is again Reena's parent. Only son of the only child of my grandfather, that means Reena's parents' only son. So, son of Reena's parent. So, we have completed interpreting the second part of the statement or sentence. So, the character described by the second part of the sentence is the son of Reena's parent. Now, we shall work on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is he. So, here he refers to the boy. Here he refers to the boy. So, we draw the boy in the photograph. So, the character described by the first part of the sentence is the boy in the photograph. Now, the characters given color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So, therefore, we merge these two characters and we obtain a figure like this. So, son of Reena's parent is nothing but the boy in the photograph. We have merged those two characters. Now, we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is Reena related to that boy? So, it is clearly visible that the boy in the photograph and Reena are brothers or siblings, right? So, therefore, Reena is the sister of that boy. And that's the answer. Next question. If X is the brother of the son of Y's son, how is X related to Y? So, here the first part of the sentence is X. And the second part of the sentence is the brother of son of Y's son. So, we start working on the second part of the sentence and we start from the last. So, Y's son. So, first we draw Y, the character Y, and then Y's son and son of Y's son. Brother of son of Y's son. So, that is nothing but the brother of A. Suppose we give the name as A to the son of Y's son, then the character now we have drawn is the brother of A. Now, that is the character described by the second part of the sentence. So, therefore, we give a color shade to that character as you see in the figure. Now, the first part of the sentence is X. So, we draw X, right? So, that is the character that is described by the first part of the sentence. Now, the characters which you see in color shades represents the same character. So, therefore, we merge these two characters and we obtain a figure like this. And now we are in a position to answer the question, how is X related to Y? Now, if you look in the figure, we find that X and A are siblings and X and A are the children of Y's son. So, therefore, right? So, therefore, X is the grandson of Y. And that's the answer. Next question. A man said to a lady, the son of your only brother is the brother of my wife. How is the lady's brother related to the man? So here in this problem, the person who speaks is a man and the person of reference is a lady. And the sentence that you see in the statement of the problem is the son of your only brother is the brother of my wife. The second part of the sentence is the brother of my wife, and the first part of the sentence is the son of your only brother. We start working on the second part of the sentence first, that is the brother of my wife. We start from the last. So my wife refers to the man's wife. So first we draw the man and man's wife, and then the brother of the man's wife. So we have completed interpreting the second part of the sentence. So therefore the character described by the second part of the sentence is the brother of the man's wife. Brother of the man's wife. So we give a color shade to that character. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence, which is the son of your only brother. So here we start working from the last. So your only brother refers to the lady's only brother, right? So first we draw the lady's brother. The son of your only brother refers to the son of the lady's brother. And we have completed interpreting the first part of the sentence. So the character described by the first part of the sentence is the son of the lady's brother. So now the characters which are given color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So therefore we merge these two characters and we obtain figure 3 as you see on the screen. So brothers of the man's wife and the son of the lady's brother represents the same character. Now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the lady's brother related to the man, right? Okay. So now from this figure, the man's wife and the son of the lady's brother are siblings. So the lady's brother is nothing but the father-in-law of the man, right? So that's the answer. Next question. Rita told Mani, the girl I met yesterday at the beach was the youngest daughter of the brother-in-law of my friend's mother. How is the girl related to Rita's friend? So here the person who speaks is Rita, and the person of reference is the girl, not Mani, right? Because the girl whom Rita met yesterday at the beach, right? So now in the sentence that we find in the statement of the problem, the first part is the girl I met yesterday at the beach, and the second part of the sentence is the youngest daughter of the brother-in-law of my friend's mother. So first we start working on the second part of the sentence first. So we start from the last. So my friend's mother here refers to Rita's friend's mother. So first we draw Rita's friend. Since we don't know the gender, we just simply write Rita's friend, and let A denote the character. Friend's mother, that means Rita's friend's mother, or in other words A's mother. So let the character be called as B. Brother-in-law of my friend's mother, that means brother-in-law of A's mother, or in other words brother-in-law of B. So that person is nothing but B's husband's brother, as you see in the figure. I repeat, so brother-in-law of my friend's mother means B's husband's brother. That is what you see in the figure, and we have given names to the characters. So D is the brother-in-law of B, or D is the brother-in-law of A's mother. Just in order to avoid confusion, we have given names to the characters as A, B, C and D. Okay. The youngest daughter of the brother-in-law. So here it means that it is the daughter of D. So we draw that character as shown in the figure. Now we have completed describing this, interpreting the second part of the sentence. So the character described by the second part of the sentence is D's daughter. So we give a color shade to that character. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence. That is nothing but the girl met yesterday at the beach. So we draw that girl met at the beach, and that is the character described by the first part of the sentence. So therefore we give a color shade to that character. Now the characters given color shades in figure 1 and figure 2 represents the same character. So therefore we merge these two characters and we get a figure as you see on the screen. So D's daughter and the girl met at the beach are the one and the same character. And now we are in a position to answer the question. The question is, how is the girl related to Rita's friend? So the girl, so from this figure we find that C is the father of A, C is the father of A, and D is the uncle of A, because D is C's brother, or D is the brother of A's father. So therefore the girl is nothing but Rita friends, or in other words A's uncle's daughter, right? So therefore uncle's daughter means the girl is the cousin of Rita's friend, or the character E. Next problem. If Banu's mother was Anil's mother's daughter, how was Anil related to Banu? So the first part of the sentence is Banu's mother, and the second part of the sentence is Anil's mother's daughter. We start working on the second part of the sentence first. So first we consider Anil's mother's daughter. So we draw that characters Anil, Anil's mother's daughter. So that is the character. Anil's mother's daughter is the character described by the second part of the sentence. Now we start working on the first part of the sentence. The first part of the sentence is Banu's mother. So we draw Banu and we draw Banu's mother. So Banu's mother is the character described. Banu's mother is the character described by the first part of the sentence. Now in figure 1 and 2, the characters given color shades represents the one and the same character. So therefore we merge these two characters to obtain a figure as you see on the screen. So Anil's mother's daughter and Banu's mother are the one and the same character. Now we are in a position to answer the question, how was Anil related to Banu, right? So we find that Banu's mother, from the figure, Banu's mother and Anil are siblings, right? Or in other words, Banu's mother is the sister of Anil. So therefore, Anil is the maternal uncle of Banu, because Banu's mother's brother. So therefore we say that Anil is the maternal uncle of Banu. Now we discuss two different problems of another type. If S plus K means S is the sister of K, S minus K means S is the father of K, and S into K means S is the brother of K, which of the following means P is the aunt of D? And they have given two options. First we work on option 1, and let us see whether option 1 is the correct answer or not. If it is not correct, then we shall go for working on the second option, right? So first, P minus M means P is the father of M. That you can see from the statement of the problem, right? We have S minus K means S is the father of K. So therefore P minus M means P is the father of M. So we draw a figure as you see on the screen. So P is a male character, so therefore it is enclosed in a rectangle, and we, as of now, we don't know the gender of M, so just we write M, and P is the father of M. Next, M into D means M is the brother of D. So therefore we have a figure as you see on the screen. So M and D are siblings. So therefore, now we have completed interpreting the first option. So I have given color shades to the characters P and D because we are going to talk something on going to talk on the relationship between P and D. So from this figure, we find that M and D are siblings, or in other words, M and D are children of P. So therefore, P is the father of D, right? So from the diagrammatical interpretation for P minus M into D, we see that P is the father of D. But they have asked, the question is, which of the following means P is the aunt of D? So therefore, option 1 is wrong. So hence, option 1 does not mean that P is the aunt of D. Now, since option 1 is not correct, we shall work on the second option. The second option is P plus M minus D. So now P plus M means P is the sister of M. So therefore, we have a figure as you see on the screen. P is a female character. So therefore, it is enclosed in a circle. Now, M minus D means M is the father of D. So therefore, M is a male character. And now we obtain a figure like this as you see on the screen. Now, we have completed interpreting option 2. So I give color shades to the characters P and D because we are going to talk about the relationship between P and D. Now from this figure we find that M is the father of the character D and P is the sister of M. Or in other words, P is the sister of D's father. So therefore P is the aunt of D. So therefore option 2 gives the correct relationship between P and D, right? P and D, that is P is the aunt of D. So option 2 mean that P is the aunt of D, right? So let us discuss one more problem. If A plus B means A is the brother of B, A percentage B means A is the father of B, and A into B means A is the sister of B, which of the following means M is the uncle of P? So here also we start working on the first option first, and then if it is not correct, then we work on the second option. The first option is M plus S percentage R percentage P. Now M plus S means that M is the brother of S, and we have a figure as you see on the screen. S percentage R means S is the father of R, and therefore we get a figure as you see on the screen. Now S is a male character, so therefore S is enclosed in rectangle. Now R percentage P means R is the father of P. So again R is a male character, and therefore we obtain a figure as you see on the screen, figure 3. Now I give color shades to the character M and P because we are going to talk about the relationship between M and P. Now P's father is R and R's father is S. So therefore S is the grandfather of P. And since S and M are siblings, M is also a grandfather of the character P. So therefore, the relation given in option 1, that is M plus S percentage R percentage P, denotes that M is the grandfather of P, and therefore the option is wrong. So therefore, we work on the second option now. The second option is M plus K percentage T into P, right? First, M plus K means M is the brother of K. Since the gender of K is not known, I just simply put K. K percentage T means K is the father of T. Now we know that K is a male character, so therefore we enclose K in a rectangle and obtain a figure as you see on the screen now, that is figure 2. T into P means T is the sister of P, so therefore T is a female character, and we obtain a figure as you see on the screen, that is figure 3. Now I give color shades to the character M and P. Now from this figure we find that T and P are siblings. K is the parent of T and P, or K is the father of T and P, and M is the brother of K. So therefore, M is the uncle of P, right? Father's brother, P's father's brother, right? So therefore, M is the uncle of P. So therefore, The option 2 correctly interprets that M is the uncle of P, and that's the answer. So option 2 means that M is the uncle of P. So thank you. If you find this lecture useful, press the like button. Subscribe to my channel for notification of updates. Share this video to whomever it may be useful. Mail your feedbacks and queries to praveen4jesus@gmail.com. Thank you.